Hello, hello. If you're just joining in, let me know if you can hear me. I'm gonna make sure everybody can hear me. You can comment. We have a few minutes until it's actually 5 o'clock. Actually 3 minutes. 3 minutes. I hope that everyone's excited about this project. Welcome back to live classes on Facebook. I have been so busy with, all sorts of art making stuff. I teach cyber school, so I've been really busy with that, and private art lessons, and Christmas is coming, so I've been really busy getting Christmas commissions ready. But today, we are going to be making Elf on the Shelf. So this is Elf on the Shelf, and we are going to be making this today. So you just need some simple art supplies to do this project. It's very easy. I'm gonna break it down and make it really simple, step by step. But first off, you need some paper. So make sure you get yourself some paper. I like white drawing paper, but any kind of paper will work. Whatever you have at home is fine. And then also you want a pencil and definitely an eraser. Go ahead and get yourself an eraser. You'll definitely need that. And I like to use a Sharpie marker. I find that this is probably one of my most used tools besides the pencil in the art studio for projects. And besides paint, because I'm a painter. But the Sharpie marker works so good for so many things, and it really makes things just look so nice and finished. And then you want some coloring utensils. So these are one of my favorite, favorite coloring utensils, are the Crayola Super Tips. I love these. These work really, really good. And plus I get the 100 count, so you have a lot of colors to choose from. And I like the tip of the marker, let me show you, because it's not like super thick, but it's not super thin. So you have a lot of different ways you can use this marker. There you go. You see, you have the fine tip, but then you can use the side of it and you can color in larger areas really nicely. So I love the Crayola Super Tip markers. If we're gonna use markers in the studio, we use these markers. They are washable. So if you're doing something where you don't want the marker to blend and you're using other mediums, this might not be the best choice. But for today, this is what I'm using. Oh, hi, Allie and Ava. Hi, girls. Hello, Aubrey and Kelly. Thank you, thank you. I'm so glad that everybody can hear me. There's so many different platforms to go live on now that you have to make sure they all work. So I'm glad they're working. Does everybody like my Santa hat? It's a little big, but I figured today it really feels like the Christmas holiday is among the Christmas holiday season is among us, especially with this snow. Hello, hello. Hi, Carrie. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. Hi, Gianna. Yes, this should record. And once it's recorded, then I reshare it. So it will be on the RLB Art Studio Facebook page. So you'll be able to see it there. Maybe it's under videos usually. I hope so. I hope it's there. Hi, Tegan and Cora. Welcome, welcome. Welcome, welcome. So if parents, if you have a chance to look through the description, I know that I get questions all the time about like the supplies we use in the studio. And gosh, the art world is crazy because you walk into Michael's or AC Moore, well, AC Moore doesn't exist here, but you walk into Michael's or like Hobby Lobby, even Walmart, and there's just so much to choose from. It's very overwhelming. Like, what kind of paper do you get? What kind of markers, pencils, all those things. So I created a Amazon store And I linked all of the supplies that we use in the studio in the Amazon store. And I plugged that link into this description for this class. So if you are looking for, you know, art supplies, like these are on there. Some of the different papers that we use are on there. Some of the more fine art materials that we use are on there. And even some of the art shirts that I have are on there. So I went ahead and I did that. Hi, Brielle! Oh my gosh, I haven't seen you in forever. And congratulations, you're going to be a big sister. That's so awesome. I'm so glad so many of you are joining in. Yay. I hope everybody had a great day. I don't know about you, but I am definitely loving this snow. I like the snow, so I was excited when I woke up this morning and I saw white. It's very beautiful. It's very, very beautiful. All right, so we're gonna wait like maybe one more minute and then we'll get started. Okay. Does anybody have any questions before we begin? Got any questions or comments before we start? I bet all of you have an elf on the shelf. I bet they've all arrived at your house. I love to hear the names. I love all the different names of the elves. There's so many. So many different fun names. I do not have one. It's okay though. I can draw one. I draw many of them. All right, again, if you're just joining in, what do we need? Hello, Katrina. It's so good to well, I can't really see you, but I see that you're here, so welcome. Oh, you know what? I miss Wattsburg too. I do. I miss seeing all of the faces. You guys are getting so big. Everybody that I had is middle school or in high school and they've graduated. I can't believe I've been a teacher that long. Isn't that crazy? Oh, your elf's name is Ella. I like that name. That's nice. Well, anyway, if you're just joining in, if you're just joining in, what do you need for this project? Well, you need a pencil, eraser, some sort of marker. I'm using a Sharpie. It's one of my favorite markers to use. You need some paper, some white drawing paper, or any kind of paper that you have. It doesn't have to be white. And then you also will need some coloring utensils. Now you can use whatever you want as far as coloring utensils go. I'm gonna be using the Crayola Super Tips. These are my favorite. I love these. All right. So, wow, you're already in eighth grade? That's crazy. Where does the time go? Makes me feel very old. But I guess that happens each year you get older. All right, so what I'm going to do is, before when I did these lives on Facebook, I kind of had the easel behind me and I did it that way, but I found a better way. I found a better way that I can draw. So I'm going to lower my screen so you can see what I'm drawing so much better. You really get to zoom in on what I'm drawing. And it's a lot easier for me to do this because I'm not like trying to get in weird angles and stuff like that. So I will lower the screen. I can still see what you're writing, so I will be checking that. And then I'll lift the screen back up so I can see if there's any comments or, you know, things like that. But anyway, the first thing we're going to do... Here he is, Elf on the Shelf. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to concentrate on the face. There we are. We're going to concentrate on his face. So his face or his head is almost a full circle. So it's almost a full circle, but not quite a full circle. So it's a partial circle, almost kind of like the letter U, but a really rounded U. So that's what we're going to do first. We're going to draw this part of his head first. Now, when you draw this, look at where it is on the paper. It is definitely not way up here. It's definitely not way down here. It's definitely, this is like the middle of the paper. It's not in the middle of the paper. It's above the middle, but below from the top. So, you know, try to get it in the right spot because you want to save room for the rest of this stuff. Like, he needs the rest of his body. So make sure you save some room for that. All right, so let's start drawing. Here we go. All right, so here's my paper. I have two sheets here. So what I want to start with, I'm going to scooch this back. There we go. So what I want to start with is I'm going to draw his head. So here's his head. I'm going to start about here. And I'm sketching it out. You know, I draw a little on one side. And then I come over to the other side and I draw the other side. So go ahead and do that. Okay, there's his head. Now make sure when you're drawing something for the first time, draw lightly. Don't press hard with your pencil. I know that that is very challenging because when we draw something for the first time, you want to press really hard. Okay, next what we want to do, so we have his head, we've got part of his head right here. The next thing that we want to do is we want to draw the top of his hat. So we want to draw the fluffy part, this part right here of his hat. So here's how we're going to do it. We are going to make a like a wavy line that looks like this, and you want to go past the head, just a little bit, not a whole lot, just a little bit. And then from there, what you want to do is you want to wrap it around and do the top portion of that fluff. It's like the fluffy, fuzzy part of a Santa hat. Okay, next step is let's go ahead and make the hat. So what we want to do is the end of the hat, we're going to make the little circle at the end of the hat. So I'm going to make that little circle at the end of the hat. Oh, you know, I'm going to put it like right over here. You can put it wherever you want. This is the end of the hat. And then from there, what you're going to do is you go from fluffy part of the hat to that little circle. So you're going to draw one side of the hat. Looks kind of silly right now, but we got to fix it. And then you jump all the way over here, right over here. And you draw a line that goes over to this circle. Like that. And there's his hat. Now from here, we're going to concentrate on the face. So we're going to concentrate on the rest of the face. So let's look at what we have to add still. So we need to add his hair. Add the hair. Need to add the eyes, the nose, and the mouth, and then his ears. So let's work on the hair first. So I'm gonna start, let's see, where do I wanna start? I'm gonna start on the edge of his head. I'm gonna scooch down just a little bit, and I'm just gonna kind of make like this pointy kind of line. It goes all the way across. It's like his hair. This is his hair. You can make the hair however you want. If you wanted to do a straight line across, you could. Maybe you want to do like a bumpy line. Maybe he's got really curly, wavy hair. Or maybe he doesn't have any hair at all. Like Gianna's brother. Gianna's brother gave himself a haircut and now he has no hair. That happens. Little kids cut their hair all the time. I think I did it too. Remember, let the professionals do it. They do such a better job. Even when I trim my own hair, I go to get my hair cut and my hairstylist is like, "Rachel, what have you been doing to your hair?" I'm like, "Well, oh, if you want to make it look like a girl, that's a good idea. So if you want to make it look like a girl, you can still do the hair at the top because that would be like her bangs. And then what you would do is you would draw some hair that comes down like this. Some here, and then you can make it come over like that. Yeah, so if you have a girl, you could do this. So that makes her look like she has girl hair. Or you could even make it like a little wavy if you wanted to. Okay, from here what we want to do is we want to make the eyes. So the eyes are two circles, one and two. So like right about here. One. Sure. This is the hardest part, is getting them the same size. And two. One and two. And then you can kind of make the inside of the eyes. And then we'll color those in later. And then we have a little curved line for the nose, just a little one. Little curved line. I mean, if this is a girl too, you can give her eyelashes. And then of course, we gotta give it a happy face. There's a happy face. And then the last thing we want to do to the face is this elf needs some ears. Now, if you want to make the ears pointy, you kind of go like this instead. Because elves usually have like pointy ears, right? Oh my gosh, the other day I watched the Christmas Chronicles. Oh, the elves are so cute. Okay, so from here what we want to do is we're going to create the collar. So we're going to create the collar, which is right here. So to do this, you're going to draw a slanted line and then another slanted line. And then from there, you're going to make a zigzag line. So up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Make that a little longer. Okay, next step is we're going to add this part of his body right here. Add this part of his body. Now to do this, we are going to draw, we're going to start at the collar, and you're going to draw a slightly slanted line, not a big slanted line, you know, like a slightly slanted line. And then one on the other side. And then you're going to close it off. Okay, the next thing we want to do is we are actually going to step away from the elf for a second, and we're going to go ahead and create the shelf that he is sitting on. So what we're going to do is, you see this line right here? You're just going to extend that line over to the edge of your paper. Like that. So that's how it looks so far. And then draw another line. Hey. How are you? It's just you, kid. So you draw another line right there. Okay, now we're gonna make the legs. So the legs, the knees, this is a little tricky because they cross. So one is in front and one is in back. So let me show you how to do this. So you're going to draw one leg. Let's see, we wanna do one, like one of the knees right here. So kind of make a curved line right there. And then you can make another curved line right here. Now we're going to go with this one. So this one, you're going to draw a slanted line from here, and you're going to go past these two lines, past this line and past this line. And then you're going to start here, and you're going to draw another slanted line like that.
I Lejo.
Okay, guys, go ahead and erase the line that is in this leg. Erase these lines right here. Get rid of those. And now we'll come back to the feet in just a second. They're tricky. Let's go ahead and work on the other leg. Now, this leg's going to be behind this one. So you're going to start here. And you're going to draw till you get to the leg. And then you're going to jump over the leg. And you're going to keep going. And then you're going to come over here. And you're going to do the same thing. You're going to draw another slanted line. Draw, draw, draw. When you get to that leg that's in the front, jump over it and continue drawing. Like that. Then take your eraser and erase this line and this little line. He's eating something. My cat Leo is eating something he shouldn't be. Cats, they do that, don't they? All right, let's go ahead and make the feet now. So what you're going to do down here is you're going to bring this around, kind of like that. Bring it around. And then from here, you're going to draw a line from here to here so that it's pointed. You want to, you can make the tip of his foot a little fancier. You curl him if you want to. You know, you can do all kinds of cool stuff. And now let's go ahead and draw the other foot over here. So we're going to start where his heel would be. So draw a little bit down and then bring it over like this. And then you're going to draw a line from here to here. If you want to, you can curl this up a little bit, like a so. I think the feet are probably one of the hardest parts. There's his feet. The next thing we want to do is he looks very strange because he's missing something that's very important. He has no arms. He has no arms. So that's what we need to add next are the arms. So to add the arms, you're going to draw a line from the collar down to where the shelf is. And you can do the same thing on the other side from collar down to the shelf. And then all we're gonna do for his arm, for his hands, is we're just gonna draw circles or ovals. I'm gonna keep it easy. Now, if you want the hands to look like they're separated from his body, there's something else you could do. So if you want the hands to look like they're away from the body, like this one, see how they're away from the body a little bit? Here's how you do that. You're just going to draw another line in here. So you're going to go from here to here. See how it separates them? It's just one little line. And now it looks like the arms are separated from the body. Okay. So that is, that's the elf, the basic elf. There he is. He looks pretty cute, doesn't he? But, you know, we want to show that he's on a shelf. So we've got to add some other things. Like, what do you find on a shelf? Usually you find books. This time of year you find Christmas decorations. So let's add some of those things. I'm going to show you how to do a couple really easy trees, Christmas trees or pine trees. Like this one. I'm going to show you how to do this one. And I'm going to show you how to make this one. And then I'm going to show you how to make the books too. So to make the books, let's do the books first. I'm gonna put the books, I'm gonna switch it up a little bit, and I'm gonna put the books over here. So to make the books, you're going to, and I'm gonna have the book going off of the page a little bit. So to make a book, I'm gonna make my best straight line. This is a tall book. Make my best straight line. And at the top of the book, I'm going to slightly curve the line. I'm gonna curve it just a little bit. By curving it just a little bit, it makes it look more like a book. And then, you know, you could do some other things in here. You can make a couple lines here, maybe a few over here. Maybe you're gonna, you could put like part of an oval here. And then I'm gonna make a smaller book next to it. So I'm going to draw, actually I'm going to draw a line that comes up. Notice I didn't draw through the arm because this book would be behind the arm. I'm going to make a slightly curved line here. And I'm going to make some lines right here. These lines that you draw inside of the books make them look more book-like, I think. There's other things you could do too. Maybe you want to like write your name in there. You could write all kinds of words. Maybe you could write the story of Elf. Speaking of Elf, I really want to watch Elf, the movie. I must watch that movie. It's one of my favorites. My favorite part is when he goes, Santa! I know him! Alright, so let's move along to the tree. The tree is going to be over here. I think I only have room for like, well, I'm going to make two trees, and I'm going to make them very small. Because I made my elf bigger. Alright, so we're going to use triangles. We're just going to use triangles. So I'm going to make a triangle at the top of my tree. There's a triangle. Now I'm not going to draw the tip of the triangle. I'm going to draw the sides and the bottom. So side, side, bottom. And then I'm going to go side. Well, I can't draw all of it over here. I'm running out of space, but that's okay because it makes it look interesting. Because it looks like it's going off of the paper. I can draw the bottom. Plus, it saves you drawing time. Side. Well, I can draw a little bit over here, just a tiny bit, and then the bottom. And then I'm going to draw the trunk. Right there. Now you can add other things to this. You could add ornaments. I'm just going to do some simple circles. And then maybe at the top, I'm going to draw a star. See if I can draw this upside down. Yeah, not too bad. Go. And now I have enough space to draw a little one right here. Now, the elf might get in the way a little bit, so I'll have to draw around him. So, and I'm going to make, I either want to make my tree taller or I want to make it shorter. I think I'm gonna make it shorter. So this time my triangle is gonna be longer and skinnier. There's one, and then you go side. Oops, I gotta go like this. And then close it off. And then side, oops, I can't really go any further. That arm is in the way. How about over here? Well, that tree is in the way. I jump over the tree, keep drawing. I'll stop there and then close it off. And then the last thing I want to do is add the tree trunk in. And then this tree, I might make it a little bit different for decorations. So I'm going to go curved line, jump, draw, curved line all the way. All right. Well, that is the drawing portion of this. Oh, my Thanksgiving was good. I had a great Thanksgiving. I saw my parents and my sister. It was very small. It was just, I think there was just a few of us. And my sister, the next day, my sister got engaged. So, yay! That's exciting. So she's gonna, you know, get to plan a wedding, and I'm sure I'll be helping with that, which is exciting. So everyone, the next step for this elf on the shelf drawing is to take your marker and outline all of the pencil lines that you like, because I'm sure there's some in there that you don't like. So just leave those ones alone. You'll erase it later. So take your Sharpie and go ahead and outline everything that you like. This is like my favorite part, outlining. And as you outline, don't be afraid to turn your paper. You can turn it any way you want when you're outlining. Also, anything that you want black, you can color in with the black marker. So I guess, where am I going to start? I'll start here. Teresa, how was your Thanksgiving? Was it good? Now, everybody, one trick about outlining is to go slow. Go slow. When you go crazy fast, you end up tracing or getting outside of the lines, and then it looks sloppy. So go slow and take your time. Now I want to show you a little trick with the eyes. When you color in the black part of the eyes, color all of it except like a little tiny speck of white. So let me show you. I'm color. And then I leave a little tiny spot and I don't color it in because that's the highlight. Sometimes when we do this with painting, after we do all the painting, then we'll go back in and paint a little white dot. But we don't have to do that with this. Go ahead and draw the nose. There we go. Also, I wanted to thank all of you that donated. I greatly appreciate that. Don't you just love how the markers really bring everything together? It makes everything look like it's so well done, like you did it professionally. It was printed out. Now, I don't Sharpie everything, but I Sharpie a lot of things. Keep in mind, Sharpies are not for your face or for your skin or the furniture. They're only for art projects. And if you use them the right way, well, then you'll be allowed to use them. When I'm trying to draw a straight line, I let this part of my hand lay on the table, and then it helps me make a straight line better. I bet these look so good. You know, when you're done with this project, I would love to see them. So you can have your parents take a picture and put it on Facebook and tag me. Or you can tag RLB Art Studio and I'll get to see it. Everyone will get to see it. How awesome you did. I love seeing the art that my students make. It's so exciting. In fact, one of my students is in the studio right now working on something. And I cannot wait to see how it looks when it's all done. He's been working on it for weeks. All right, my last few things to Sharpie here. Okay, I think I Sharpied everything. I better double check, because I always miss something. I think I got everything. All right, now the next thing you want to do is after you Sharpie, there's always pencil lines left over. Like, look, you can see the pencil lines. So I take an eraser and I get rid of all of them. Oh, these are my favorite erasers, the pink pearls. They work so good. And I think I did link these to the Amazon store. I think they're linked in there. So if you want a good eraser, oh, these are the best. I bought really expensive erasers, but these ones are better. Now, next week I'm doing something really exciting. I'm having an art sale online, an art sale. I don't know if anybody needs anything for the room, any artwork, but I'm selling all kinds of my art on Monday on Facebook. Pretty excited. I just finished up this frog today. He looks so cool. Been trying to think of a title for him, and I think I figured it out. Padre. I think I'm gonna title it, "I'm Here for the Party." Or "Here for the Party." All right, so our next step is to add the color. It's time to color. So obviously you can color this in however you'd like because it's your artwork. I'll show you how mine look. And I do want to show you a couple tricks with using a marker. If you're using a marker, I want to show you a few tricks with using a marker because all of this, guys, this whole thing is used with marker. I use those super tips, those Crayola super tips. These are great markers for all ages. They're washable. Crayola makes a good product. They really do. So I'm going to break these out. This is the 100 count, and this is linked in the Amazon store. Let's see. So you can color this in however you'd like. I'm going to look for, let's see. I'm going to look for a, go with this color. I'm going to show you a couple tricks with coloring with markers because I see kids use markers all sorts of ways. So sometimes I see kids get a marker and they go like this. Scribble, 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 scribble. They kind of color all over the place. There's no pattern. They're kind of what happens though when you scribble like this. Sometimes it's good, sometimes you don't want that. What happens is you end up using a lot of the ink and there's not a whole lot in here. So you want to make your markers last as long as possible. So check this out. This is so cool. You color in a pattern. So instead of using the tip of the marker, you turn the marker and you use the side of the marker. I just wasted it a little. Don't tell. So I'm going to color the leg in first. So I'm going to start at the top and go all the way to the bottom. Watch this. And I'm going in one direction. I'm using the side of the marker. And then I come back up to the top, back up to the top, and see how I just keep scooching over? We've done speed tests before to see what's faster, the scribble method or this method. And this method is actually faster. And look at how nice it ends up looking. Look how nice that looks. It's colored in so nicely. So then I can go back over here and do the same thing. I'm using the side of the marker, not the tip, just the side. Now, another trick with markers is when you use markers, you always want to keep them stored with the tips down. Tips down. You always want to have the tips down of the marker. And that's so when they're stored. So, what I mean by that, tips down, you store them like this. You don't want to store them like this. You want to store them like this because when they're like this, then all the ink goes to this part of the marker. So they dry out way less quicker. So you want to do that. It's definitely one way that I do. So when I have this box of markers, I take this box of markers. Might seem kind of silly, but I'm telling you, it makes your markers last so much longer. You close your marker box up and then tip it upside down. And then when you're ready to use it, you can open it this way. And then they're ready to use. And you can see them all too. It works really good. I store all my markers like that. If you come to the studio, then you know that. Speaking of coming to the studio, next week on Tuesday from 5 to 6:30, there is 4 spots left for an awesome art project. We are going to be creating a project called The Reindeer Crew. It is a painting and a oil pastel project. So we're going to make portraits of the reindeer. So you usually have enough space to make 3 reindeer. They turn out so cute. I love this project. And actually, I haven't done this project in some time. So I'm excited to do it. So if you are interested, it's next week from 5 to 6:30. And there's only 4 spots left. Only 4 spots. I'm only taking 6 students at a time. So everybody can be spaced apart and have their own supplies. Go ahead and color in his hat now. And I'll also show you the Reindeer Crew project. All right, now you want to, if you can, you have like a skin tone, flesh tone colored, you can color his face in that color, whatever skin tone, flesh tone you want to use. But I want to show you something with the cheeks. And the nose, because we want the cheeks to look rosy and the nose to be a little pink. So you color the face in first, and then you're going to pick out a red or a pink, so I'm going to go with this pink. I've got a pink here, and I'm going to go right over top, so a little there, and then a little over here. And then a little above his nose. Here we go. There's that. I need to finish working on the rest. Now his collar right here, if you want to jazz it up a little bit, you can go ahead and draw some lines in here like this. If you want to. You could even give his hair some more texture. Now it almost looks like he has black hair, but it can be any color you want. There's tons of new stuff. Isn't that cool? All right, what else could we work on here? So your shelf down here, this can be any color. The rest of your picture, you know, like I said before, it can be any color that you want. Ooh, let me show you, because we're getting close to being out of time here. So let me grab the project that we are doing next week, the Reindeer Crew. It's so cute. So here's what we did today. So next week, let me grab it. So next week on Tuesday in the studio from 5 to 6:30. Again, there's only 4 spots. This is what we are making. Oh my gosh, is it not like the cutest thing you've ever seen? It's reindeer and it's Rudolph and some of his friends. This is acrylic paint and oil pastel. So that is next week. And then I'll be offering another live class very soon. I have to look at my schedule, but I will post about it on RLB Art Studio website and on the Facebook page. And also, if you're looking for some awesome art at a really decent price, check out the online art sale that is on Monday. Baby Yoda will be up for sale, among many other pieces. There are some really fun ones, great for any room in your house, really. Kids' rooms, offices, living rooms, bathrooms. So that is what's coming up. Thank you all so much for coming. I hope that you enjoyed creating Elf on the Shelf. I know I had fun. Now I have many of them. I don't know where I'm going to hang them all, but I will find places for them. Does anyone have any questions or comments before I say goodbye? I hope that you share some of your pictures with me. I'd love to see your elf on the shelf. All right, well, everybody have a wonderful evening, and I hope I see everyone soon. Thanks again.